With its rapidly evolving information gathering and technological capabilities, along with its cutting-edge unmanned weapons of war, for better or worse, the United States military is poised for global domination far into the future. But it won't just do it with unmanned planes, tanks, and ships. Warfare is about to go next level, with America's imminent completion of a system of satellites, unmanned spacecraft, and cyber weapons that will give it control over all levels of Earth's atmosphere, including space. Few Americans know just how close we are to this unprecedented moment in history, as the details of these Defense Department projects are highly classified, but we do now know enough to form a clear picture of how the overall plan works. To start, a fleet of hundreds of powerful drones, like the $200+ million vehicle Global Hawk, will continuously patrol the lower altitudes. With their high-resolution cameras and powerful surveillance sensors, they're already the remote-controllable, all-knowing eyes and ears of the US military. Launched from over 60 bases and 10 aircraft carriers around the world, these drones can monitor and precisely strike nearly any target on Earth. Giant solar panel-covered unmanned aerial vehicles with 400-foot wingspans, like the Vulture, will stay in the air continuously for years gathering data. Hypersonic vehicles capable of traveling at 13,000 miles an hour at an altitude of 20 miles up will be able to get to and bomb any location on Earth in under 120 minutes. A network of ultra-wide-angled space surveillance telescopes will allow for real-time monitoring of any object anywhere in the sky from a bay of computer screens. To completely control the planet, vehicles like the X-37 will patrol space, ready to track down and eliminate an enemy satellite at a moment's notice. The 30-foot-long unmanned vehicle completed a 22-month non-stop flight in 2014. Destroying a satellite from land with a missile, the way China did in a 2007 test, creates thousands of tiny pieces of space debris that could trigger a Kessler effect, a runaway destructive event like the one depicted in the blockbuster film Gravity. Experts think that just 10 to 15 of these types of explosions could create so much debris that low Earth orbit would suddenly become a no-go zone. That's why future weapons that target satellites will try to disable or jam them instead, or use lasers or an agile space vehicle like the X-37 to push or drag a satellite back toward Earth where it would break up upon re-entry. As a countermeasure to this, the United States is developing many smaller satellites instead of the traditionally larger ones to make its system as difficult as possible to attack. Paired with this growing armada of satellites, the world's most powerful computers will coordinate all of these capabilities by gathering, storing, and analyzing staggering amounts of information. And taking into account America's already best-in-history military, the US government is set to dominate aerospace, cyberspace, biometrics, and robotics far into the current century. And there's no reason to think the US will hold back. Its current track record of runaway weapons development and relentless drone strikes in the Middle East, Afghanistan, Pakistan, and North Africa proves that the Americans will use every tactical advantage to dominate the theater of war. And it'll likely set off a new arms race, as every game-changing weapon developed in the past by the military-industrial complex of the United States has eventually been embraced by other countries. Fighter jets are now used by dozens of countries around the world. 6 nations have nuclear submarines, 11 have aircraft carriers, and 9 have nuclear weapons. Recently, when the NSA created a portfolio of cyber weapons, other countries, like China, immediately began copying them. In the past, America has been unable to prevent other countries from building warplanes, ships, or even nukes. However, it'll soon be the only country, with the possible exception of China, capable of stopping its rivals from launching or keeping their satellites in orbit. But this seemingly impenetrable 21st century coat of armor may still have one significant weakness. If the American computer programming force can't keep its increasingly vital and complex systems from being successfully hacked by its enemies. Thanks for watching my take on the global military landscape of the near future. How do you see it? And if you think this is a conversation worth having, like this video to help it spread. Click on the video on the left to watch our rundown of the future of military robotics technology, or our visualization of the nuclear arms race. And if you want to go deeper down into the rabbit hole of cyber warfare, take us up on our offer for a free trial of audible.com, linked below, and get a free audiobook of your choice, like Shane Harris's At War, The Rise of the Military Internet Complex. You have to put your credit card in, but it's free to try for the first 30 days, and just for signing up, you get a free audiobook, and you get to feel good about helping us continue working on these videos, as Audible contributes a little bit back to our channel. Until next time, for the two-man team here at The Daily Conversation, I'm Bryce Plank, along with my brother, Brendan Plank, the editor of this video.